capacitive sensors work by detecting the change of capacitance introduced by the finger touching near the electrode. Such change is so small that detecting it unambiguously is challenging and has become the primary task for the application design. The capacitance that the sensor IC is measuring is from a sensor port with respect to the circuit ground. Two conductive plates are required, one connected to the sensor port and the other one to the circuit ground to form a capacitive transducer. So the ground plane is not just like a shield in a standard PCB layout design, but it is also an indispensable part of a two-plate capacitor. Being the front end of the sensor, the electrode's ability to pick up the signal from the finger has a direct and significant impact on the overall performance. For the surface capacitive transducer, the reason an external object would increase the capacitance is that the electric field projected from the transducer polarizes the object, and the polarized charges in return attract more charges from the source to join the transducer. The increase in the charge storage on the electrodes means the increase in the capacitance. The capacitance is more sensitive to the external object if the electric field is projected more into the air to reach the object. The electric field projection or distribution depends very much on the transducer's layout design, and therefore, the layout design has a direct effect on the transducer's sensitivity. In the classic parallel plate capacitor, the electric field is so confined in between the plates that the capacitance could hardly be influenced by the external object. This means that a touchpad directly above the ground plane is a poor capacitive transducer. When the plates are shifted apart from overlapping, more electric field will be projected into the air and the capacitance will be more sensitive to the finger's influence. A pad with a ground ring projects some electric field into the air, and therefore it is a good electrode for the touch button application. But to further increase the sensitivity for proximity sensing, the ground plane got to be further away. In this simulation, the finger influences the capacitance from a further distance, and the touch signal is stronger. But when the finger moves to the ground plane, the same amount of signal can also be read. With similar signal levels, the sensor IC cannot differentiate the touch on the touchpad from the touch on the ground plane. As the objective is to make the touchpad the only sensing port, methods to sensitize the touchpad and to desensitize the ground plane is very much needed. One common method is by putting the touchpad closer to the user and hiding the ground plane deeper inside the housing. Another method, which is the centerpiece of this video, is by having a bigger ground plane compared to the touchpad. Automatically, the sensitivity will always shift to the smaller plate, which is the touchpad. Since the total charges on both plates are the same, the plate with the smaller area will have a higher charge density, more concentrated flux lines, stronger electric field, stronger polarization force, and therefore more sensitive to the influence from the external object. In this simulation, a touch on the touchpad gives a 62% change in the capacitance compared to a 7% change for a touch on the ground plane. With such distinctive signal levels, an appropriate threshold level can be used to differentiate the touch on the touchpad from the touch on the ground plane. A rigorous explanation for the shifted sensitivity is by means of mutual capacitance between the human and the touchpad, C of TF, and the mutual capacitance between the human and the ground plane, C of GF. As these two mutual capacitances vary with the human movement, they disturb the overall capacitance. The disturbance pathway is in series, so C of TF and C of GF each imposes an upper limit on the disturbance. When the finger closes the gap at the touchpad and provides a good link, the bottleneck of the disturbance rests on the remaining link, C of GF. By having a big ground plane constantly coupled to the human, the bottleneck is eased and the signal will be strong. When the finger moves towards the ground plane, the loop is not closed properly, so the signal will be weak. This is the mechanism behind the inverse property, which gives the higher sensitivity to the smaller plate. In summary, a big ground plane, non-overlapping with the touchpad, will give two positive effects: the increase in the overall sensitivity and the shift of the sensitivity towards the touchpad. Such advantages can be fully exploited by connecting the circuit ground to the mains wiring, which is the biggest ground plane readily available. Naturally, the signal captured will be the strongest, and the sensitivity will occur at the touchpad because of its relatively smaller size. The grounded chassis and the mains wiring, though a bigger part of the transducer, will produce minimum signal even when touched because of the inverse property. I find it amazing that the inverse property happened to be compatible with the standard design rules, big ground plane and earth circuits. Had the inverse property not there, we will be getting false triggers from touching the ground plane and the earth line. I hope you enjoy the video, and in the meantime, I'm working on the projected capacitive sensor.